shit. Time to put up or shut up. All right. Let's see what we got here. As everybody knows, poor Jeff has been trying to cast this light switch cover, and I guess it's a dog keychain holder, I suppose. Let's see what he says. Well, it hasn't worked out too well for him. And me and my big mouth said, good luck. Jason, good luck. Have fun with it. Hope I didn't put you in a spot too much with this. I couldn't resist. Nah, it was my fault. Looking forward to seeing the results. I threw in the candle holder from one of the videos for you. I don't know if it's something you would even want. Just say my way of saying thanks. I was all out of butt plugs. Oh, my God. All right, Jeff, I got your number, buddy. You are getting this when I'm done. The butt plug award. Jeff, the boho mutt. Let's see. Hey, now that is one fine looking casting. That looks really nice. You got even a little bit of soft fuzziness on the back. Ah, man, thank you. I appreciate that. That's really nice. Awesome. Yeah, wife's gonna like that. And she's gonna want me to make her more. Thanks, more work. Okay, let's see what we got. This is, okay. A busted light switch cover. What is this thing made out of? It's made out of plaster. It's pretty. Okay, I wish it would have survived, but that's okay. We can stick it back together. Not a big deal. All right, and yeah, she's a little on the thin side, looking, this is fine, but this is definitely a little on the thin side. I think the solution with this is probably going to be stick it back together and park it on a little layer of wax, something just to give us some more beefiness here, and run a silicone mold of it, and then we'll do the ceramic shell. All right. Now let's look at these dogs. Oh, those are cool. Yeah, my wife is definitely going to want one of these. So thanks, buddy. Now I'm not just making one. I got to make a few. And Mr. Dogs are busted. And once again, yeah, they are a little on the thin side. I don't know why you were having so much trouble getting the tails to fill. My plan, I think, yeah, that's really cool. For those of you that haven't actually got to see this really up close. Yeah, because those tails are fairly thick. Alright, so. Yeah, it's going to be JB Weld to the rescue on this one. Silicone mold. I don't see anything in here that's too thin that I need to build up. I think I'm going to just go straight to silicone with this. Put this back together. Straight to silicone. Oh, we do have a little bit of... Yeah, I thought they were sitting a little flatter, but yeah, that makes sense. I got a whole keys. So. Yeah, no problem. Yeah, no problem. All right, what else we got? Well, that's it. Well, let's do it. Let's see, anybody have any idea how to connect plaster back together? I have no clue. Let's see, I think we got some smell good stuff here. Maybe super glue, I don't know. Let's hold it tight. Let's see what happens. Oh shit. Goal is to not attach this thing to my workbench top here. obligatory boring part. I'm mixing JB Weld. You ever read the package on this stuff? It's like Farmer John in Armpit, Kansas, welded together his cylinder head on his tractor and saved $5,000 or something. Quite the good reading on the back of these packages of this stuff. Today's music is Mr. Stan Getz and Astrid Gibralto? Gibralto? Everybody remembers a chick from Ipanema. Ipanema. Alright, time to see if we can patch these dogs. Put the dogs' asses back together. The girl from Ipanema goes walking. Got a wax paper. Really handy. Keeps everything from sticking to shit. I can burn the paper off if I have to. This is probably going to take a couple hits of this stuff. Just try to at least get the dog sitting correctly. And then we can always hide the repair later and then goop up some more on the back. I'm going with that. That's about what I believe it. That should look like. Do, 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 do. Once we have the wax, we can clean this up and put the detail back in if we have to. Hopefully we won't lose too much. In case any of you are wondering, this thing appears to be some kind of cast iron, or it's pig iron, or pot metal, or whatever, but it's got some heft to it. I'm surprised. She's, what do they say, she's got a little gravity to her? Yeah, she definitely got a little gravity to her. Now, this is probably going to happen fairly quick out here. Today, it's got to be 90 degrees in this garage, I'm guessing. Let's do that. Let's see what happens. Absolutely never ever build a 12 foot long workbench, because you will end up working in a 2 foot area and the rest of it turns into a giant shelf. Absolute dumbest idea I've ever had. Now we need to make, let's put this back here so it doesn't get broken again. We need to make some more of these. I decided I am going to add a thin layer of wax as a buildup on the back of that light switch cover. This is too thick. This is every bit of an eighth to 3/16. So this is using, it's not quite a quarter, but this is using Zap's method with the plaster, with a piece of steel inverted, and then you add the plaster and then dump in the hot wax. That's fine, but I need it thinner. And in order to accomplish that, I'm going to do the hot water method. So what we've got, let's put the dogs in a safe spot while they can dry. Yeah, they still look good. So we have to get the wax rolling. Now over here, we have the pot. See if we can make this thing work a little better. All right, everybody see the pot? This is how microcrystalline comes. Those of you that haven't seen, I know we got a couple new guys. Comes in blocks. You just take it, break the stuff up, and away you go. Let's plug in the pot and get her cranking. That's it. See that? I mean, you can make them go a little faster with a flame if you want, but Now I got a pot's real clean here. These little induction cooktops are really pretty funky. Yeah, starch, thank you. You have to have a steel pot. They won't work with good stainless steel cookware, so you gotta buy junk. So that means Goodwill and wherever the heck else you can get it. And my wax tool, that's called a screwdriver. There we go. And just get the stuff spinning. Yeah, just put it in motion and she will melt. What you can't see is in the kitchen right now, I've got a pot of water on the stove. I'm gonna get that pot of water to probably a good 170, 180 degrees, and then I'm gonna fill up a silicone pie plate. I don't know what this one of these things. This is another piece of shit from Goodwill. And I'm gonna use that and fill that up with water, and then layer on a real thin layer of wax because I need it to harden and be flat. And then we're gonna attach it to the back of that light switch cover. And I am gonna take a little bit of thickness. Sorry, that's just the all I can do with it. And just keep the old wax a-turning. Yeah, pretty boring stuff. All right, let's pour some wax. Yeah. Oh, shut up. Yeah, I know. Pulled this off the stove, but she was a little on the boiling side. Let's roll with that. Yeah, that's good. Another great use for an anvil. If you need to cool something off, you stick it on an anvil, and that will cool it fast. Picked this up at a garage sale. A whole buck. All the batteries in it are worth more than a dollar. Thing was brand new. It was never even used. Guess it's for sticking your steak, I guess. I don't know. All right, what do we got? Temperature of the water is 175, pushing 180. That'll work. Good. Fairly close to the wax. That's really what you want. My wax is, it's probably 190. 180 maybe. Yeah, give it a little swirly swirl. Now, this takes some practice as to how much wax you take and actually dump into the water. If you dump it in and it runs all the way to the edge, it's gonna be about 3/16 of an inch. So we don't want it that thick. So let's see what happens. And the wax, maybe you guys can see, let's go this way. The wax kind of floats on the top. I don't really want to go all the way to the edge. I want this piece to be kind of thin. Let's go with that. Looks like my workbench isn't level. Big surprise. Oh, there we go. I'm going to get some of the bubbles out. I learned this one from Zap. Floating in there. I didn't exactly wash this garage sale, find out. So let's see what happens. That's alright. We're only using it to build up the thickness, so. Do 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 do. Ask, how long does this take to set up? Well, a while. There we go. Wow! Holy cheap shit! Looks like I'm due for a new Burns-O-Matic valve here. This valve sucks. It's either full on or full off. That'll work. Good enough. Now, hot wax to water? No problem. Hot water to wax? Big problem. Never go the other way. That's like the old acid to water trick. Always acid to water, not water to acid. And that's it. Let it solidify and go from there. Well, gotta love Goodwill and their cheapo shit. Now, my little silicone dude here is cooled down, and my wax is nice and solid. You can tell when the wax is solid, you just watch the color of it. It gets dark. Ah, very nice. Very nice. A little thick around the edges. That's my tool bench here. That's not exactly the most level thing going, but it appears to be pretty damn thin, and that is really all I was after. Just add a little bit of thickness to the back of that light switch, and we will move on. Get rid of this. That best part about a stainless steel worktop. You just scrape the crap off. This is the remnants of David's butt plug. Let's see what we got here. Yeah. Alright, this seemed to be nice and solid. That'll work. Back in the pot it goes. Oh yeah, that is a really, really nice thickness. Beautiful. That's a great thickness. I'm impressed. That floating wax on water, that's... Damn. That's a brilliant idea. Whip out the glue! This is definitely a one-use pattern here. I need to hurry up and get it into a mold before I lose it for good. Like to stick this sucker to it, but I don't think I can get it. I don't think I can get it heated evenly. Oh, what the hell? Let's try it. Shit, I don't know, maybe this will work. Probably stick it to the bench. No! Blowtorch! One shot. All right, winner, winner. That'll work. Just something to keep it from dancing around on there while I add this. I just kind of wish that was a little thinner, but it is what it is. All right. So this gave us a little more thickness on our switch cover here. I guess I better probably put these in because I'm gonna have to locate that at some point. And that'll be fine because when it, the ceramic shell goes over, it's gonna encapsulate all that anyways. It'll be no big deal. I'll just bust it off. We're gonna be doing this in bronze just because, well, I don't really care about aluminum anymore. Aluminum's nice and whatnot, but my thing is bronze, so I'm gonna do it in bronze. I'm gonna make a hole for these guys here. I think we're just gonna indent these. That's how we're gonna handle these. And those will be drilled in the final part. To try to cast a hole, that's stupid. We're not gonna cast a hole. So somebody recently was asking about tools and whatnot. Here, I'll give you guys a little 2-second tour. This little guy I found, I think at Michael's. It's got that little plastic little ball on the end of it. I actually have a set of these. I have like 4 or 5 different tools. This is the one actually I use the most. Silicone tip on the other side. And I wish this was metal. I think it's actually plastic. I don't know. But good ball tool. Good for cleaning up stuff. Wife came out one day, gave me this little purple thing. And it's another ball. I think it's basically the same size. Yeah, it's basically the same size as that one. But it's a little smaller. And this was like an eye makeup brush or, I don't know, some other piece of garbage. I have a slew of these metal tools. This is what I basically use the most. I like the wax and crap on this one. Hair or fuzz. I like the big scooper-doop, so I can get this thing heated and pull up a chunk of wax and park it where I want, so I use that one. And these guys, I use some more wax tools. These are just various different, let's see if I can get you a shot, there you go. This one's kind of a good booger hooker. It's got kind of a pointy on it, so that makes it handy. And then we have another little semi-round tool here, and then this little brother. On the other side of these knives, on the other side of these are knives, which are handy for cutting. The colors, this is nothing more than that Fimo oven baked clay. And the only reason I put this on here was when you're hanging on to a tiny tool like this guy for hours on end, your hand starts to really, really hurt. So by giving yourself something to grip and you're working, hopefully it'll prevent, you know, injuries. That's what I use. Not a lot of tools. I've got a lot of tools. It's just you kind of figure out, you know, there's more in a way, more options. I don't know. It's whatever, simple. Keep it simple. I do use this little guy. These are for pottery. I use this quite a bit actually for scraping large sections of wax. So that one I do use. And then everybody's heard about the famous booger hooker. This is a booger hooker. It's just nothing more than for pulling cotter keys. And I use this sometimes. I get it hot and I use it for almost like stitching pieces together. Let's see what other tools we got. Cheapo alcohol lamp. You get these online for about $8. They usually come with an extra wick or something. Burn denatured alcohol in these. It burns clean. No black, sooty, smoky shit. But it evaporates. I can fill this thing up inside of 2 weeks, it's empty. So the best way to get denatured alcohol I've found is I go to Home Depot and get a gallon of it. And that's what I use for that. Acetone. Walmart. I still believe this is the cheapest. I like it because it's in a plastic bottle. I'm not tugging around a gallon of this stuff. This is like $1 something or $2. 100% pure acetone. It doesn't smell like flowers or anything, so I use this for cleaning up metal. Let's see. All right. Back to work. And I think the only thing I'm really gonna do with this guy is just kinda feather the edges around here so we kinda keep that shape of this light switch cover. Real simple. This is the mirror. I don't know what this is made out of. I think it's some kind of resin, whatever it is. I'm sure it's Chinesium. It says May on the back. Either way, I paid a buck for it at a junk store. And a cool little mirror, I guess. And the artwork on it was really pretty neat, so. But this is gonna be a whole lot nicer if it's in a proper metal instead of some kind of plastic garbage. So we're gonna cheat and steal the artwork on this one and run a mold the same time that I've got the silicone out for these other two pieces. So we'll do all three, just get them all done at one time. All right, we're all dammed up. This is plastilina clay. This is a really, really soft garbage. I absolutely hate it. It shows every tiny little mark and fingerprint, and it's just awful to work. I'm sold on working wax these days. I'm not messing with this stuff. So it works really good for disposable purposes. Throw it away, it's pretty cheap. It's really soft. You get it at Hobby Lobby or Michael's or just about any place else. The clay, if I have to work, that stuff on that frame up there, that's a lot harder. That's a little nicer to work. So, what I'm saying about the doggy tails is that there's a negative space that lives below the tail, and we're going to go over the top of this with silicone. So we don't get the tails trapped. Basically, I just dam them up like that, and that'll solve it. Now, the dam running around the outside of it is just to kind of keep the silicone from going everywhere. I figure, you know, if it's going to run, it's better for it to at least build up a thickness. Here's a little mirror that we have over here, and she's ready to go. So that's it. Not really a whole lot of time up to this point. Dorking around, gluing the dog and gluing this thing back together. It's basically ready. I think I'm going to hit it with a real light spray of Moldies and then get going on silicone. So that's coming up next. All right, let's get these molded up. Tonight I'm using Rebound 40. Comes in a box like this. This is actually 2 pounds. It's a pound of part A and a pound of part B. I have not used Rebound 40 before. It's a little stiffer because I'm planning on running this for the lantern roof, and I need more stability. I don't need a flippy floppy around just due to the size of it. I think it's just gonna make my life a little easier. So it says here, you will be amazed. So much for that. Combine equal parts A and B, mix it together, dump it over, and away you go. It also brushes on very good. It is a brushable one, and it does handle undercuts very good if you have them. We don't have any undercuts here, so you could actually get away with a straight silicone, platinum silicone, or tin base, I guess, whatever you want to use. There isn't any sulfur in this clay, so we're okay. If you're using like old school Roma, you gotta watch that stuff might have sulfur in it, and it reacts to certain platinum silicones. This is a platinum silicone. What I do is I've got two containers. Nothing really cosmic here. I measured them out with water and then put two identical marks on. Oops. And one of them is gonna be will always stay with part A, and then the other one will always be part B. Whichever one's lighter, I can't remember. Huh? Shit, yeah, of course they're sealed up. Let's talk about the mold release. It's cheap insurance. You don't have to have it. I know people complain about the price of it. I think it's like 20 bucks maybe for a can. But this can, when you see how little you use, this can will last me years. So there's no reason not to use the right stuff. Make it easy. I think you shake, put a mist on it. You're supposed to brush. I don't brush. And then another light mist. And then let's stand 5 minutes before you do it. And that gives you plenty of time to be mixing up your silicone anyway. So give this stuff a little shake, shake, shake. And then you're not really trying to paint it on. You're just giving it a dusting. And I didn't even hit the mirror. before you do this to grandma's prized vase, I'd make sure that you find out if she wants the damn thing back. That could be a problem, I guess. This is probably not the best stuff in the world to breathe. Yeah, I guess at least nothing will stick to your lungs. Good enough. Shit. Brutal. They say you're supposed to stir this stuff. I guess it depends on how long it's been sitting. I don't usually jack with it. If anything, I just try to collect most of it and keep it in the damn jar just because it's so pricey. But this stuff isn't really even that bad. Alright, let's get something, put that on. Trash can. I use a, this is a piece of acrylic. I took it, shaped it one day on a belt sander somewhere, using it to spread sealant inside of airplane fuel tanks, and good thing is it cleans easy, so that's what I use it for. Let's see what color this stuff is. 25 is, you saw, it's kind of that putrid flesh color. I think this is purple. Huh. Blue. You probably noticed by now the plethora of chip brushes sitting here on the bench. You're going to go through a lot of them. One container to mix. I measure out in each one equal parts and then dump it into one, and that works. And you know when you're ready to move on with the next coat is this thing. Will be stuck. I'm gonna mix it in this container here, and it'll be stuck to the side. When you pull it out, everything will come right out with it, and then you have a nice clean bucket, and you can press on. So, let's start with, see what I mean? I don't have a 12-foot workbench. I have a 9-foot long shelf and a 3-foot workbench. So, there we go. I gotta do something about a camcorder one of these days. So we're trying to get to the mark. Whoa! This stuff is a little more runny than the last stuff. See how we do. Pretty damn close. First coat should go on straight. You get what you get. That's known as your print coat or your detail coat, and that's what's going to get the real fine detail. Now, we don't have any fine detail here. There's nothing. This is just simple shapes, so we're not trying to mimic veins in a leaf or anything. So probably could almost just go straight to adding a little bit of Tyvek to it and press on. Now, this stuff here is a little thicker. Let's try that. That's a learned skill, be able to dump it out without getting it everywhere. I think the goal is we probably want to have 3, maybe 4 coats, something like that. Yeah, we'll go for one more. What the heck? If I can mold all 3 of these with just these, little 1-2 pound starter kit, then I'll be pretty happy. That's good enough. Whoa, shit, look out. So much for a skill. You guys having fun watching me play with this disgusting stuff yet? Being a YouTuber is not anything that I've ever felt like doing. I make fun of people on YouTube. I don't want to be one of them jackasses. our world today is full of enough self-absorbed, narcissistic bastards anyways. The last thing I want to be is one of them. Okay. A and B. Is it about 5 minutes? Sure. I'm drinking the wrong stuff tonight. I'll be back. I'm gonna fix that. Let's do this. It's handy that the stuff is two colors like this. When you no longer see any streaks in it, then you're good. After it's mixed, you get about 20 minutes to get the job done. So don't think around, just get it going. The first coat you need to actually let sit up for about an hour. And you know when it's done because you can touch it and it'll feel sticky, but it won't come off on your finger. And that's how you know that you're probably ready for your next coat. When it's finished, I think you gotta wait about 6 hours or something. Basically, I'm gonna stay awake tonight until all the coats are done. And the coats will be finished, and then tomorrow we can start dumping wax. Y'all, I bet, expected me living in West Texas to be doing some country music or Garth Brooks or something, huh? Yeah, not quite. Not quite. Jay starts getting a little thick. Let's go for it. Let's do it. This one's not stuck down, so I'm gonna hang on to it. Dab, dab, dab is the name of the game here. Air bubbles you don't really want. Get them. Not the end of the world. Because an air bubble is just gonna show up as a pellet on your wax once you make your wax mold, and then you just get rid of it. Biggie. The dabbing is really if you're trying to pick up surface detail for whatever reason, so and we don't have any detail here. We're just trying not to sandcast these dogs and make it work. then, of course, do it in something cool like bronze. Fill that little part up now. You can pour this stuff as a solid mold, too. It doesn't have to be brushed on.
If there's one thing the pros at Advance Auto know, it's parts.
Advance Auto parts and batteries.
I'm on your website and it says I can buy online and then pick up in store?
Yes.
And how long does that usually take?
30 minutes or less.
I need a battery for my 2013 Ford Escape.
Our Autocraft Gold, it's got a 3-year warranty.
Man, you really
AutoZone battery. That is the world's worst battery.
Cardigan. Cardigan.
Advance Auto Parts. We know everything.
Advance Auto Parts. Auto Parts. Yeah.
Order online.
Just as bad. AutoParts.com. Advance AutoZone. It's all junk.
Also at participating CarQuest stores.
Goopy doop the doggies. Can you guys see what's going on? Looks like it. Yeah, right. That's good. Gotta keep moving. Stuff starts getting pretty thick pretty damn fast, so you don't really want to futz around with it too much. Just need to get it where it's got to be. This is just the first coat, and the rest of them just start building up layers, so that's the main thing, is don't dink around. This stuff is definitely thicker than Rebound 25. I can already feel it. It's definitely thicker to push. 25, the first coat is like water. Well, not quite like water, but it's pretty thin by comparison to this stuff. Get that little doggy's butt. The dog with Mr. No Ass. I got one of them. Whoop, head. And if you miss and you gotta go back over an area, this stuff will actually flow out and meet and mix, and you won't even see where the two subsequent layers had to be joined. It's really good about that. You know, the little thing of why something sometimes costs so much? The correct answer is because it's worth it. There we go. Ooh, I don't know. We're gonna try. See if I get my little mirror covered. Crap, I thought I was going to be running Tyvek with this stuff. I do not see me using Tyvek at all. This is, this stuff is thick enough for what I want. Yep, turn my lazy butt off the stool. Arm is probably in the way. Sorry, I have to deal with it. I'm right-handed. My camera's actually pegged in the vise right now. I don't have tripods and all this other stuff. And the vise is to the right of where I work, so that only makes sense. But y'all were wondering what I was gonna do with that mirror. I'm going right over the summit gun. I could care less. Yeah, I paid a buck for this thing. What do I care, right? It's actually worked out pretty good. That was good timing, Jeff. You know, that thing's showing up because I did want to do this frame. And I was out of crap, and last week I had to run to Phoenix one day. So I threw all the crap in a plane and dragged it home. So that actually worked out good. It's just as easy to do three like this as opposed to just doing one. So that doesn't bother me at all. So don't feel like you're putting me out or anything, but it's all good in the hood. Let's see if I can salvage more of this. Pig's ear out of this thing. Alright. So this container gets left aside. This goes in the trash. And now we'll be able to see when we're ready for the next coat. That sucker will come out. Let's see if my Cabernet is the right temperature now. This thing's nasty. There we are, first coat, done and done. All right, put through out of the vise. So now you kind of see the reason for the dam. It's just to kind of control some of the runoff and actually put it to use, as opposed to just watching it run all across your bench. Just kind of makes sense. And yeah, the little doggy tails are all good to go. Yeah, I'm gonna need Tyvek. I have to stiffen up the next one. I can see where it's pretty thin on the dog's tail, and a lot of it ran off. That's not a problem. Next coat will have just a little bit of a thixotrophic stuff added to the mix. And you'll see it'll just be a little thicker than what I had used. And it helps it kind of sit up a little bit better. This is just the print coat. And that's it. So I have some work to do on that, and we will see where we go here in an hour. Not bad. All right, away we go. Not bad. All right, away we go. All right. Hope you're enjoying the show so far. I managed to scrounge up my Tyvek, this stupid little bottle. You don't use very much. Lasts a long time. You'll probably lose it before you'll blast through all of it. It is a silicone thixotropic agent, and its job is to make the next coat a little thicker and not so runny, and start to build this up. That's what you really need to do, is get some thickness on it now. The print coat is done. You can check to see if it's dry. I waited a little longer than an hour. There may have been two or three glasses of Cabernet in between there, but it's okay. You can walk away from this stuff now and come back tomorrow and continue putting on coats. Silicone doesn't care. Silicone sticks to silicone without a problem. Saved you some of the boring stuff. Let's see how what I said about this jug. This stuff here is obviously dry. Let's see if this method works. Oh, look at that. And she just takes and pulls right the hell on out of there. Dink. And then you end up with this. And it just pulls away. And there you go. Ugh. Okay, I saved some of the details for you. I've already pre-measured out part A and part B. And we're just gonna take and dump it in, and we will keep on rolling. Ooh. Nope, yeah, you missed that one. Well, yeah. Oh, the joys of editing, I hope. I have zero editing software, so don't give me any crap, folks, please, over editing. I'm probably just going to take and put all these files on my phone and then just join them together, and you see what you see, and hopefully... I'll be doing good as long as I keep my mother from seeing this. Alright, here it is. I am going to get a good hard premix on this stuff prior to adding the thixotropic stiffening. He said stiffening. The stiffening agent to it. And get a fairly respectable start here. The proportion of this junk is, I think, 1%, so who the heck knows what 1% is. I do a squirt, or a half dozen drops, and that seems to have been working so far. None of this stuff is an exact science. I mean, let's face it. I'm in a garage. Ugh. All right. Thixotropic, gentle shake. And we can go 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, there you go. That's good. That's good. And give her a mix. Once you eventually start getting really, really thick on some of the latter coats, you will find a paintbrush is not exactly your friend. You will not be able to push it with a paintbrush. You're almost better off with a spreader like my little acrylic friend here. I'm going to start with a paintbrush, but I certainly won't end up with it, I can tell you that. Pull the loose hairs out of my Chinese chip brush. And here we go. Make it happen, Captain. Let's start with the dogs. So yeah, sorry, Myford, I know you're not going to want to watch my video. You'll get 5 minutes into it, and you'll either get tired of hearing me ramble, or you won't like my music or something, buddy, but I'm sorry. Can't please everybody. I just know I can't stand watching the Silent Mystery Channel. That's TCM on Sunday nights if I want to see a silent movie. You notice I'm paying mostly attention to the dogs, just themselves. It's going to run, even with the thixotropic stuff. It's still going to run a little bit, and it'll find its way down further down the line, so not a big deal. this one you're not super concerned with air bubbles. You want to try to kind of avoid them if you can. Make sure you got a fairly healthy buildup over those areas. The quality of the job of the silicone is directly proportioned to the size of your wallet. I'm sitting on a lot more silicone, but I certainly don't want to blast it all on my little dollar store mirror. See what I'm saying? As this stuff gets a little on the thicker side, you kind of end up spooning it on. And this way you're able to push it. I'll throw some more on the dogs and keep building them up, especially around these tails. Anything that's sticking up, like an arm, let's say if you're doing a little man, he's got an arm or something, wherever there's a... Probably should have been a two-piece mold, but you wanna build that area up. Jesus. Any of you have never tried doing this before, videoing it, and then I guess I don't know, shit. Try to seem mildly entertaining, talking to yourself in a garage, sweating your balls off. At, what is this, 3:40 in the morning? You gotta try it. It's a lot of fun. A glass of wine makes it a little easier. So there we are. Coat number 2, complete. Webley Edwards, and featured many of the top Hawaiian entertainers. What is this, number 3?
The show ran
God, it feels like years, 19. 1935 to 19. We're good. Trash. Put that in there. Well, here we go. It's 4:45. I'm on the last coat. Yes, it's time consuming. No doubt about it. Thank you. If you decide to try this lost wax thing, don't overthink it. I did for a long time, and there is zero reason to overthink this process. There's just steps, and just do the steps in the order, and you'll be all right. None of this takes any skill, any training, no artistry, just steps. And if you can follow simple directions, you can do steps. I'm done.